different type of sentences are there based on its meaning. First is statement, simple. Second is question. Now, if I want to make a question, how can we make this a question? How can we make this a question? What we do, we bring this here and this will go to this place. Now it will become a question. Is Ramu a good boy? This makes a question and this will replace by question mark. Is Ramu a good boy? It becomes a question now. First it was a statement. When it was a statement, it was a simple sentence or affirmative sentence which states, which tells something about a person or thing or anything. This chair is brown. This chair is brown. This pen is white or blue. When it writes, it is blue. When I say this color is, this is white. So when it writes, it is a blue. When it writes, it is a black. So this gives a statement about anything. So first type is statement. First type of sentence is a statement. Next, is this pen a blue pen or is this chair red? This become a question. So is this? This makes a question here. So what we do, is Ramu a good boy? Now it becomes a question. It becomes a question. Now, first type is simple. Second is interrogative. I will write that first, okay? I will give you in detail when I will go to the sentences type. First is simple, second is negative, third is interrogative, fourth is negative interrogative, fifth is imperative, and sixth is exclamatory. I will give one example. Now I just wanted to know, is it clear to you when I make a question? Is Ramu a good boy? Now, if I ask you to make a negative sentence of it, Ramu is not a good boy. Ramu is not a good boy. So what is the definition of a negative sentence? Definition of negative sentence, you must know why a sentence become negative. Why a sentence become negative. What is the reason? It has no meaning. It has negative meaning. This is not a red pen. This is not a red pen. When I say it is not a red pen, means it is giving a negative meaning. Anything which is negative, that is called a negative sentence. Anything which comes and gives negative meaning, the meaning comes no, not. That is a negative sentence. So Ramu is not a good boy. This is third type. This is third type. Next, fourth type is what? Is not Ramu a good boy? Is not Ramu a good boy? This is question with negative meaning. Did not I say that it will be difficult for me to come in morning? Did not I say? This is negative interrogative. Means I say. It gives a sense that I say that it will not be good time to come in morning. So did not I? That is again negative interrogative. This is fourth type. Then fifth type is imperative. I say close the door please. This is an order or request. Order or request. So this is fifth type. This is an order or request. And last is exclamatory. Oh, you come very late. This is an exclamatory sentence. Oh, you are boring. Alas, he is dead. Alas, he is dead. Hooray, we won the match. So this sixth type is exclamatory. It gives sudden feeling, sudden expressions, whether it is a wish or sorrow or sadness. Okay? So these are six different types of sentence by meaning. Six different types of sentence by meaning. So now let us come to the first four types of sentences based on structure and complexity. What do you mean by structure? What do you mean by structure? Our body. What is the structure of our body? Skeleton. Bony cage. We have bone inside. And we have joints. Okay? So the whole body is based on structure. What is the structure? Bony cage. We have all bones from last toe to skull. Everything has bones and it has joints to move, and to move the joints we have muscles inside. If I want to move, the muscles is pulling and releasing. If I want to raise my hand, muscles are stretching so that my hand will go up. If muscles are not coordinated, to coordinate the muscles I have the brain here. From brain, the nerves passes the message to my hand to go up, it's going up. When I pass the message go down, it is going down. So everything is in a system. If brain is not giving any order, my hands will not work. It will be like that one. If everything is there, the message is not passing to the place where I have to do the action. If I think 100 times I want to move, I cannot move it because there is something lacking. There is a gap from here to here. The message is not passing. There is a cut down. Message is not passing. Everything is there, but it will not function. It will not work. So likewise here, when we speak about the structure of sentence, here is a very simple example of sentence. First of all, let me tell you about the basic structure of sentence. What a sentence contains. Any sentence, any small sentence. What is the structure of a sentence? Yes, tell me. Subject and predicate. Excellent. The basic component of a subject of a sentence is a subject and predicate. I go. How many words are there? 2 words. I go. This part is called subject and this part is called predicate. So any sentence must contain a subject and predicate. What we are saying and about what we are talking. I means a subject. I, myself. Go, action. So this part is called subject and this part is called predicate. So any sentence should contain a subject and predicate, and predicate can contain a verb, a noun, a phrase or anything. That is a different thing. When I say Ramu is a good boy, in etymology we learn about parts of speech. And when I speak about structure of sentence, the basic type is simple. Second, I say compound. It's a mixture of two sentences. I come to the class, but But I come to the class, the sentence is complete here. But there were no students. But there were no students. There were no students is a complete sentence. I come to the class also a complete sentence. But is joining. There is a river. Line here, line there. So it works like a bridge. I come to the class, but there were no students. So this becomes first one, I come to the class, basic sentence, simple sentence. But there were no students, it makes this simple sentence into compound sentence, mixture of two things. Mixture of anything singular, separate is a sentence. Here two sentences become a one sentence. So it becomes a compound sentence. It's a mixture of two things. Okay. After a compound, there is a complex sentence. After second type is simple, compound, complex, compound, complex. So the smallest sentence is a simple sentence. I go, simple sentence. Ramu is a good boy, simple sentence. Okay. Third example I given, it's a compound sentence. Now we'll come to know what is compound complex. First is simple, second is compound, third is complex. How the complex becomes? See, there is a small building, small house, simple sentence. There is a compound, there is a garden, there is ground floor, there is second floor. This is compound. There is a compound. Compound street. This is a complex building. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So this is simple, compound, complex. This is a commercial complex or residential complex. Third level. And there are 5, 6 buildings together in one place. That is compound complex. Very easy to understand. So there are 4 types based on the structure. Structure means what is the structure of this building? This is the structure. On this, the whole building stands. So when we make this, what is the structure of the sentence means? Subject plus predicate. This is the structure. Subject plus predicate. Subject plus verb. This is the structure of the sentence. Subject plus verb. Now, in this sentence, Ramu is a good boy. Here, Ramu is a good boy. There are 5 different words from 5 different categories, 5 different classes. So in etymology, we learn about the parts of speech. We'll go one by one. So now the structure of sentence is based on structure, simple, compound, complex, compound, complex. These are 4 types. Then based on meaning, we have 6 types. Simple, negative, interrogative, negative interrogative, imperative, exclamative. So these are 6 types, these are 4 types. So structure of sentence is subject plus predicate. It can be subject plus verb plus object plus anything can be, okay, plus anything can be, so and so on. So the sentence become more complex. The sentence become more complex. Sentence become more complex. When the sentence become more complex, the size of the sentence will increase. When I say I go, it makes some sense, no? I go. What does it mean? What does it mean? I go. I ride. Tell me, what is the meaning of I ride? Are you getting my point? I think difficult for you. Finding difficulty, no problem. You will come to know step by step. You, are you getting my point? Not getting my point. What do you mean by I write? What do you say in your language? I write. I write. I write a letter. This becomes a sentence. This is sentence, this is sentence, this is sentence. So we are adding I subject here. Plus verb. Plus adjective. Plus object. It becomes this structure of sentence. So the sentence starts from the smallest part and it can be bigger, even bigger, even bigger, even bigger. So it is based on the structure. We have four types: simple, compound, complex, compound, complex. Now when we say I write a letter, it is a moderate, simple sentence. I write a letter. But if you want to make the same sentence even bigger, I write a letter to my father. I write a letter to my father. It becomes compound sentence. To father. To my father. To my uncle. To my friend. To the principal. You can add anything else. Okay? Even bigger, I write a letter to my father who lives in England since 10 years and I haven't met him since then. The same sentence continues and it becomes so big. So the last one is compound complex sentence. Small, bigger, more bigger, most bigger. So the sentence can be small, big, bigger, biggest. So it depends on the thing what you want to express. Simply, I write a letter, one sentence. I write a letter to my father, another sentence. I write a letter to my father who lives in England since 10 years. A sentence. I want to write even more. I want to write a letter to my father who lives in England since 10 years and since then I haven't met him. Again a sentence. The same sentence can be smaller, bigger, more bigger, most bigger. So here what we learn, the basics when you read, study class 1 book or you study higher level of English, the rules, the grammar, the basics will be same. There will be no difference. So you have to learn from the lowest to the highest. When you don't understand the lowest, you cannot read the highest at the first level. So you have to go step by step. You have to learn the basics. After that, you will come to the books, will take some basics and will practice on it. So here today we learn, I will sum up the values completely. In the etymology, we learn about the classification of words. I said in the beginning that a word is made up of alphabets. So any word here, we have used a sentence, we have made a sentence. Ramu is a good boy. This makes sense. Ramu is word, is word, a word, good word, b word. So that comes in etymology. In that etymology, we learn about words types, words classification. So we learn first parts of speech. In that we learn noun is the first part of speech. Pronoun. What are parts of speech? Do you know? Parts of speech. What are parts of speech? How many parts of speech are there in English language? Eight. What are they? Good, very good. Now, pronouns. How many? Just count and tell me. Now, total how many? Eight. Good. So try to remember the sequence which I am telling you. That is easy to understand and easy to apply when we learn in detail. So the first one is noun. Second is pronoun. Third is adjective. Third is adjective. Fourth one is verb. The sequence can be changed, but the sequence which I am telling you, it is more easy to understand because it comes step by step. When you climb up, you first take first step. You don't take third step first. Okay? So go step by step. Step one, noun. Step two, pronoun. Step three, adjective. Step four, verb. Step five, adverb. Step six, preposition. Step seven, conjunction. Step eight, interjection. So there are eight parts of speech. And whenever, whatever you read, write, understand in English language, you need to know these basics. After knowing these parts of speech, first of all, we'll take noun. The definition of noun. Definition of noun. What is the definition of noun? What does noun mean? What is the meaning of noun? Okay, we'll learn about that. Definition of noun. Then we'll discuss about the examples of noun. Then third, we will learn about the usage of noun. Usage of noun. How the noun is used in sentences. That is called usage. Okay? So likewise, we will do for pronoun. Same thing, definition, examples, usage. Same thing for the adjective, same thing for verb, same thing for adverb, same thing for preposition, same thing for interjection, and same thing for conjunction and interjection. So likewise, after knowing this all, second step, we will learn, we will discuss, we will study about types of nouns. How many types of nouns are there? Okay, there are different types. Same thing we learn about pronoun. How many types of pronouns are there? Okay, and then we learn about the conjugation of noun. Conjugation. What does mean of conjugation? What does mean by conjugation? Conjugation means the same word can be used in different manners. Here the word boy is used. What is the number of boys? Singular or plural? Singular. When I want to make it plural, what I have to do? I have to add as boys. When I ask you what is the gender of boy? Male, female? Neutral gender, common gender? That is called conjugation. That is called conjugation. When I say pronoun I is what? A personal pronoun. It is a type of pronoun. In that category, it comes in the category of personal pronoun. When I say I, what is the number of I? Singular or plural? Singular. What is the plural of I? What is the plural of I? What is the plural of I? We. What is the person of I? First person, second person, third person. What is the person of I? Third person, first person, second person, what it is? How many types of persons are there? What is the person of? Gender? Okay. And what is the gender of I? So this we learn about the conjugation. Conjugation of noun, conjugation of pronoun, conjugation of verb. These are very much important things. Without knowing, you cannot learn English. Without knowing that, you cannot learn English. So when I say I, it is the first person. The person who is speaking is the first person. I. When I speak to you, you become the second person. You become the second person. I am talking to you. You means second person. And same you is used for plural also. If I say your class is finished, you can go now. Means you all, not one. Okay? So it is a common for singular and plural. In the same manner, a person is not present. A person is not present. And we are talking about him. He is not present here. Who is that? The person who was sitting here. So the person who is not here present is third person. He went away. He was sitting here. He went away. So he is the person, third person. I, first person. You, second person. He, she, it, third person. They, third person. He, she, it, singular. They, plural. So these are the conjugation of pronoun. When I say I, it is meaning that I myself. The same I become, this is I pen. Is it correct? What it should be? This is my pen. This is not I pen. This is? What is the reason how this I become my? Don't talk to I. Is it correct? Don't talk to me. I become me. What is the reason how it become me? Don't talk to me. If somebody is saying right English, he will speak, don't talk to me. If you want to say, don't talk to me means, don't talk to I, he will not say. Don't talk to I. Don't talk to me. So why it becomes me? The reason you should know. I becomes me. What is the reason why it becomes me? In what condition? This is called conjugation. Variation in the same word and different meanings. I myself drove the car. I myself drove the car. I myself made this building. So it shows that the person himself has done this work. You yourself cut your finger. You yourself cut your finger. I have not cut your finger. You yourself cut your finger. So this becomes the variation in the basic form. When I say I see, I saw, I have seen. What is the difference in see, saw, seen? Why it becomes saw in different word? Why it becomes seen in different word? And why it becomes seeing in another word? So these are different forms of verb. See is the basic form, that is the root word. Saw is the second form. Seen is the third form. Seeing, fourth form. I want to see, fifth form. So these are the variations that is called conjugation of verb. So likewise we have conjugation of noun, conjugation of pronoun, conjugation of verb. And when we study about adjectives, there are comparison of adjectives. Big. Big is the word that is adjective. Big. It is a big pen. I have a bigger pen have a bigger pan than this. So there is a comparison between this pan and another bigger pan. Bigger. Big becomes bigger. I have a biggest pan. Biggest pan. So this becomes the degrees of comparison. Adverb. This adjective fast becomes adverb fastly. The same adjective fast becomes adverb. It adds something to the meaning of fast. It add means adding something. It increases the meaning fastly. So this is adverb. Preposition and conjunction are connecting words. Interjection is the sudden expression. So, in etymology, we discuss all the types of words. All the types of words we discuss in etymology. And once you know all these words, then you will be able to place the correct word in correct place. Otherwise, you will not be able to do so. So, that is why we have to learn what is the type of words, what are parts of speech, what words comes in what group. You have to learn that first. You cannot put noun in pronouns place, you cannot put adjective in adverbs place, you cannot place preposition in conjunctions place, you cannot put interjection at nouns place. You have to place the same word at the same place. For that reason, we have to study etymology and deep